In this video lecture, we'll be seeing PLSQL procedures. PLSQL procedure is nothing but a PLSQL block with a name. You can call this procedure by using its name. The procedure is a subprogram that consists of PLSQL statements as well as SQL statements. PLSQL procedure is nothing but a normal SQL blocks. It consists of declaration part, which is optional, then execution part and exception handling part, again, which is optional. For any procedure, you have to pass values through a parameter and fetch the values again by using parameters. There is a return statement, but return statement doesn't return anything. Everything is through parameters only. There are two ways of executing it. You can call it from another procedure, or else you can use exec keyword. This is a structure of a procedure. So your statements start with create or replace procedure. Create means a new one, or if the process is already present, then you have to replace it with the current one that you are actually writing, followed by a procedure name, then a list of parameters. Now parameters are declared as in, out, or in out. Then the procedure starts with as. So you have create or replace procedure name as. If in case procedure is nested within another procedure, then you have to use is. Otherwise you have to write as. Then comes a declaration part like any other PLSQL blocks, then a begin and exception handling. Every parameter in PLSQL procedure has to be declared as a data type. So if I declare x, then whether it is integer or character, I have to mention it. Along with that, I have to also write whether it is in, out, or in out. Now why this? In PLSQL procedure, there is a return statement, but it doesn't return a value. So if you have to get a return value, you have to do it through a parameter. So while declaring a parameter, you have to tell the procedure whether it is incoming or outgoing. If it is outgoing, it will only pass on value from the function to a calling function. Or if it is in, then the calling function will be passing on the parameter to this procedure. Or if it is both, then you have to declare it as in, out. We will see all these things in examples. Let's try to write a simple procedure. So I am declaring procedure as create. That means if the procedure is not present, then he will create it or replace. If the procedure is already present, then he will replace it with the current one. Procedure and name of the procedure. So I am giving greetings as begin DBMS output dot put line, just writing something that is hello. And that will end the procedure. Let's see what happens here. So he says procedure is created. Now how to call it? For that I am writing exec greetings. So I am getting output as hello. I am writing a procedure in a notepad so that if there is an error, or I can make some changes easily. So let's try create or replace procedure, and here I am giving some name. So I am written greetings again. Here I am trying to pass on parameters. So I am writing a it's a in parameter. So I am writing in and number is as
begin DBMS output dot put line, and I'm trying to print A and finish. So let's try to run this here so we can make it changes later on to the same thing. So a new procedure is created. Create or replace procedure greetings A in number. In means this particular parameter will be passed to a procedure here. So let's try to call it. So I'm writing declare because I need to pass on value of A, or let's try to make it simple, begin. Here I'm trying to call this procedure. So greetings into bracket, I can give a variable. So I'm giving to and let's see the output. So my output is 2 here. Here I'm making a simple change. Instead of writing create or replace, I'm only keeping create. Let's try to run this and see what we get. So this is my procedure. Put it here. And he gives me error as name is already used by an existing object, because procedure with the same name greeting we have already created. Here let's make some change to this procedure. The first parameter was in, that was the parameter that is passed to a function. The parameter that you pass to your function is mostly read only. You can pass any literal or a value here. While calling, it can be a variable or it can be a literal. Here I'm passing another one, B. I'm calling it out number again. So now it is B, which is out. So this is a variable which can be assigned value in the function itself. So I'm writing here B equal to A. And let's try to create a procedure. So here I'll have to write create or replace, otherwise he will give me error again. So let's try to run this. A procedure is created. So now let's try to check the value. So begin, sorry, I need to declare, because I need to declare a variable for that B. So I'm writing X number then begin greetings. Let's pass on some value. So I'm passing 2 here and then X as parameter. Here I'm trying to print the value of B. DBMA output dot put line, and let's print the value of X and let's see what the output is. So my output is 2. Now this 2 is because I printed a value here of A, and this is a return value. Actually, if you see the procedure here, it takes second value as B and B equal to A, and that B is written over here. So I get a 2 here also. Okay, let's change something here. So if you see this, A is declared as in and B is declared as out. That means A is parameter to a function and B is a return value. Now as such, I'm trying to change the value of A also here. So A equal to 4. Let's run this first. So let's come here. He gives me procedure created with compilation errors. There are some errors. So what is that error actually? Because I assigned value to A. So let's make some change here. I'm making A as in out. So if you see this part, it's A is declared as in and also out, both. So let's create this one. Now he gives me procedure created successfully. So while calling now, I'm trying to call this declare, because I need to declare two variables now for A and B. Because it is declared as in out, I cannot pass a literal, I have to pass a variable. And because B is declared as out, I have to pass a variable here. So declare x number I'm giving value as 10, because this is the in parameter also, so I have to initialize it. Then y as number, this out parameter, so don't have to declare initialize it to anything, I'm keeping as it is. Begin. Now let's call the function greetings x comma y. These are the parameters that you're passing, and let's print. Y. In fact, I can print A also here. So I'm trying to print both Y as well as X. End block. Let's see the output. So the output I get is 444. Now I passed a value as 10, but here I am making A equal to 4, B equal to A. That means B will also be 4 now. And printing value of A here, also I am printing Y and X here. So for X also I am getting a changed value, that is a 4. In PLSQL, we also have a return statement. So before going for return statement, let me copy this. So I am copying this to a notepad here, so that it is easy to make changes. So in PLSQL, there is a return statement also, but return doesn't return anything. Return will only return the control to the calling program. So here I am writing in this return. Let's try to run this. And it says me procedure created. Let's try to execute this one. So he says PLSQL procedure successfully completed. But if you see the output now, because if you see the program, there is a return statement, and after that there is one another statement. But because of return, the program will return to the calling program, and this will not be executed at all. So the output that we see here is for these two lines, Y and X.